Hello everyone. In this video session, I am going to explain part 86 of Java for tester series, that is using for loop with a three-dimensional array. In the previous videos, I already covered how to use the for loop with a single dimensional array and also two-dimensional array. And in the current video session, I'm going to explain how to use for loop with a three-dimensional array. So what will be the difference, guys, on using the for loop with a one-dimensional array and two-dimensional array and three-dimensional array? I already covered how to use for loop with a single dimensional and two-dimensional as part of the previous videos in the series. And the current video session, I'm going to explain how to use for loop with a three-dimensional arrays. So let me tell you the difference of using the for loop with one dimensional, two dimensional and three dimensional now. Okay, if you are going to use for loop with this one dimensional or single dimensional arrays for iterating through all the values that are stored in this array, then you got to use only one for loop, guys. Only one for loop is enough for iterating through all the values that are stored into this one dimensional or single dimensional arrays. But coming to the two dimensional array, for iterating through all the values stored in this two-dimensional array, we have to use how many for loops? We have to use two for loops. Okay, we have to use two for loops. And coming to the three-dimensional arrays, how many for loops we have to use for iterating through all the values that are stored into this arrays? As guessed, guys, it will be three. Okay, it will be three. Three for loops are required. Okay, for iterating through all the values that are stored into this three-dimensional arrays. So in this video, I am going to practically show you how to use three for loops for iterating through all the values stored into this three-dimensional arrays. So let's switch to the practical mode, guys. Okay. So as you can see, there is some program already written here. Okay, which I have explained as part of the previous video. Okay, in the previous video, I explained how to create a shortcut representation for a three-dimensional array, and also I explained how to find the size or length of the this three-dimensional arrays. Then in one of the other videos, I explained how to access the values stored into this three-dimensional array. But here, as you can see, how many statements are there, guys? Okay, 1, 2, and 24 statements are there here, and I am going to replace all these 24 statements with simple for loops, guys. I'm going to use three for loops instead of this 24 statements. Okay, where we have to write each and every statement separately. Instead of that, I'm going to replace all these 24 statements or more with this for loop. Okay, so let me clear out this stuff, guys. Okay, let me clear out this stuff. And here I'm going to use for loop, okay, with this three-dimensional array. This is a three-dimensional array, guys. I'm going to use for loop with this three-dimensional array. How to use three for loops, guys? Keep that in mind. So I'll start with the first for loop, guys. First external for loop, and I will create a variable I and initialize this variable with 0. Okay, because this is a three-dimensional array. In this three-dimensional array, there are two-dimensional arrays, right? The first two-dimensional array is having the index 0, and the second two-dimensional array is going to have the index as 1. So I will start with the index 0, and if I say i less than, I have to give the size of the number of two-dimensional arrays I have to give. How many two-dimensional arrays are there in this three-dimensional array, guys? For that, I have already found out, right? The number of two-dimensional arrays in this three-dimensional array are nothing but a dot length. I did this in the previous video, guys. If you have not gone through the previous video, just go through that and come back here, guys. You will understand what I'm talking about. And here, this a dot length will give you the size of this three-dimensional array. That is the number of two-dimensional arrays in this three-dimensional array it will give. So I'll simply use this a dot length here, guys. Okay, I less than a dot length. That is nothing but, in this example, it is, there are two-dimensional arrays. So first two-dimensional array is this one, and second two-dimensional array in this three-dimensional array is this one. So two are there. So a dot length is nothing but two. And put a semicolon, and then say i++. Increment the value of i. And after going inside this first for loop, we have to create another for loop. I have to say for int j is equal to 0. Okay. So why I'm saying j is equal to 0, int j is equal to 0 here? Because after going into this, let's say this index 0 is there, okay, and in this first two-dimensional array, again there are three single dimensional arrays. First single dimensional, second single dimensional, and third single dimensional. That like that, three single dimensional arrays are there in this first two-dimensional array. In order to iterate through that, okay, we have to get the size of this two-dimensional array, right? So here it starts with the first single dimensional is index 0, guys, then index 1. Since it is starting with index 0, we have to give the j is equal to 0 here. Okay, then j less than the number of single dimensional arrays in this two-dimensional array. Either this two-dimensional array or this two-dimensional array, if you count, there are only three single dimensional arrays. 1, 2, 3 are there. In the second two-dimensional array also, we have 1, 2, 3 single dimensional arrays. So how to get the size of these two-dimensional arrays? For that, the number of single dimensional arrays in the first two-dimensional array are a of 0 dot length, it will result in 3. And also the number of single dimensional arrays in the second two-dimensional array are also a of 1 dot length, it is also resulting in 3. Either you can use a of 0 dot length or a of 1 dot length, anything is fine, guys. Okay, I'll use this a of 0 dot length, which will give me the number of single dimensional arrays inside this two-dimensional arrays. Okay, that is 3. Then j++ I have to give, and I have to open and close the curly brackets for this internal for loop. And inside this for loop, we have to create another for loop. Int k is equal to 0, I have to say. Okay, why I have to say int k is equal to 0? 0 is the index value, guys. And that is nothing but when you go to the single dimensional level, okay, as you can see, okay, there are 4 values. And the first value index will be 0, guys. That's why we have to start with 0 here. Now we have to say k less than the size of the single dimensional arrays. If you go through all the single dimensional arrays that are there in this three dimensional array, either this one or this one or this one or this one, this one and this one, as you can see, everywhere we can see only 4 values available. Okay, so we have to give that size as 4, guys. Okay, how to get the size of the single dimensional arrays? The number of values in the first single dimensional array are a of 0 dot length. No matter you take any single dimensional array here, guys, you will get the length as 4, guys. Okay, if I give a of 0 1 also, okay, a of 0 1, that is 0 is okay, 0 is this one, a of 0, right? A of 0 is this one. Okay, a of 0 is this one, and in that again 0 is, in that again 0 is what, guys? This one. Okay, 0 is this one. So if I give 1 here, it will take this part. Okay, it, even if you take this 1, a of 0 1 dot length, what is the length, guys? 4. You'll get the 4. So no matter which single dimensional array you choose, you will get the length as 4, guys. So I'll consider this, okay, for now, and give k less than a of 0 0 dot length. All the single dimensional arrays in this three dimensional array of same size, so I'll give a of 0 0 dot length. Okay, if I give a of 1 dot length also, you'll get the same result, no issues. Okay, k plus plus I have to say, then I have to provide the opening and closing curly brackets. Inside this internal for loop, okay, we are done with the three for loops, guys. And I will write a print statement saying that, I will write a print statement saying that a of i j k have to give, guys. Okay, so how this will work, how this for loop will work, it will take a lot of time, guys, if I have explained this, but I will try to explain at a high level for now. So when I run this, this three dimensional array will be created, then okay, all these lengths and sizes will be printed, that will be fine. Then we'll come to the for loop, and here int I is equal to 0, okay, this will be executed first, the value of I will be 0 here. Okay, then a dot length is nothing but 2, guys. Okay, number of two dimensional arrays in this three dimensional array are 2, so that is nothing but 2. So here 0 less than 2 is true, it will go inside this for loop. Then j will be initialized with 0, so the current value of j will be 0, guys. And then this condition will be verified where 0 less than a of 0 dot length is 3, guys. That is number of single dimensional arrays inside each and every two dimensional array are 1, 2, 3, so that 3, guys. Okay, 0 less than 3 is again true, it will go inside this for loop, and again the third for loop will be executed here, int k is equal to 0, k value will be assigned to 0, guys. And here k less than a of 0 dot length, that is the size of this array, that is 4, the side of this single dimensional array in this three dimensional array, that is 4, guys. So here 4 will come. Okay, 0 less than 4 is true, 0 less than 4 is true. So I'll go inside this for loop and it will print a of ijk, that is a of 0. What is a of 0, guys? A of 0 is nothing but this one, guys. Okay, first of all, a of 0, this is a, guys, this is a, in that a of 0, a of 0 is this part. Okay, and the next 0 will be, and the next 0 will be this one, guys. Okay, first one. And in the in this single dimensional array, again 0th index is 1, so that 1 will be printed here, guys. Okay, like that, guys. This complete for loops will be executed one after the another one. Okay, so next what will happen? The control will come here and k plus plus will happen, that is k will become 1. So 1 less than 4 is true. So here a of 001 is this 5 will be printed. Then k will become 2. 2 less than 4, true again. We'll go here, a of 002 is this one, 7 will be printed. Then k will become 3. 3 less than 4 is again true. We'll go inside, a of 003, a of 003 is this 7 will be printed again. Then k will become 4. 4 less than 4 is false, 4 less than 4 is false, so it will come out of this for loop. It will go here and it will increment the j by 1. J will become 1. So 1 less than 3 is again true. It will go inside this internal for loop. Again, k will be assigned to 0. So 0 less than 4, again true. It will go inside. So a of 0, 1, 0. What is 0, 1, 0? 0 is this one. In that, 1 is this one. And 0 is 3. So 3 will be printed. Like that, guys, each and every element in this three-dimensional array will be iterated across all these for loops. Okay, all these for loops will be iterated. Finally, all the values will be iterated. So for this, we need 3 for loops and we have to iterate something like this. Okay, it will keep on incrementing, and when each and every condition fails, we'll come out of all these for loops and all these items will be printed. So when I run this, right click run as Java application, you see all the values in the array got printed. Okay, that is 24 values will be printed here using this for loop. And you can do some formatting here, guys, if you want this values to be printed something like this. Okay, two-dimensional arrays need to be printed, let's say, okay, separately, and three boxes should be there. So it takes time, guys, so it takes time. So you have to give some print statements here. So I will say system.out.println, and here also I will give another system.out.println, and here I, instead of this, I will give normal print and append this with some space. I already explained why we have to append space as part of the single dimensional array explanation. Okay, two dimensional array explanation I gave how, why we have to add the space. If I don't give space here, what will happen? Let me check. Okay, if I remove all this stuff, okay, I will remove the additional formatting, guys. When I ran this, I got this output, right? When I ran this, I got this output like this. But if I want to, okay, print all these values in the same line, so I have to say, instead of this println, I have to say print. If I give println, guys, if I give println here, it will print the same way like this. Okay, 1, 2, 3, all the values will be printed like this. But if I want to print all the values in the same line, I have to make this println to print. So when I run this, you can see that in the same line all the values will be printed. Now I want to add spaces between all these values. For that, I have to add, after printing each and every value, I want to append some space. Now when I run this, right click run as Java application, you see each and every value there is a space, 1 space 5 space, like that 3 space. Okay, now guys, all the values got printed in the same line. Instead, I want to divide something like this, okay, into two parts, 1 part and 2 part, first array, first two dimensional array values, and this three dimensional array is a combination of two dimensional arrays. So first two dimensional array values and second two dimensional array values. For that, outside this in the first for loop, okay, inside the first for loop, at the end of the second for loop, I'll add system.out.println like this. When I run this, you'll get that result. Okay, right click run as Java application, two sets will be printed. Now this will become to this values belong to the first two dimensional array of this three dimensional array, this values belong to the second two dimensional array of this three dimensional array. And again, in this two-dimensional array, there are three sets of single-dimensional arrays, right? First set, second set, and third set. If I want to print separately, okay, what I would do? In the second for loop also, after this third for loop, I will add system.out.println like this. Okay, when I run this, you will see the difference. Right-click run as Java application. You see, first two-dimensional array and second two-dimensional array, and the combination of this two-dimensional array will give the three-dimensional array. So this is the expected formatted output, guys. Okay, this is the first two-dimensional array of the three-dimensional array, and this is the second two-dimensional array of this three-dimensional array. Okay, so this is how people expect the value to be printed in the output. Okay, people expect the three-dimensional array to be printed like this in the output, guys. For that, we need to do small modifications like removing this println, changing this println to print, and then adding some space here, and then adding this println statements in the second and third for loops after the end of the internal for loops. Okay, like this we are going to get the result, expected result like this. So this is how, guys, we have to use for loop with a three-dimensional array. Looks complex, but when you practice it, guys, it will become simple. Okay, when you clearly practice it on your own, it becomes very simple, guys. So I suggest you to guys to practice it on your own, how to use for loop with a three-dimensional array. Okay, so that's it, guys. In the next video session, I'm going to explain how to use for each loop with a two-dimensional array. Okay, I didn't explain how to use for each loop with a two-dimensional array in the previous videos, guys, so I'm going to cover that in the next video session. So that's it, guys. See you in the next video session. Thank you. Bye.